Without you, my friend, and it hurts me.
So we've got the tractor Sunday still, we're still collecting sand, but one of the wheels is coming loose. There's only one bolt holding it, so we need to find an adjustable spanner. There's only one adjustable spanner around, and it's about 3 kilometers down the road. A guy called Obreem has got one, so they sent me off on my push bike to find it. So now I'm just going down single road tracks here for 3 kilometers, and here it is.
My two bolts.
Cool.
Yes.
See you later, buddy. Bye.
Thank you.
I worry about one.
But are you the happy? Okay, as I've been cycling back and forward to the health clinic, there's a nursery school here that I wasn't aware of, and the kids keep saying good morning to me, so I've just come to see how they're doing, and found out they don't have a blackboard, and their roof has no plastic on and has lots of holes in it, and rainy season is a couple of months away. So as a little sideline, I think we'll just sort this out for you guys, yeah?
Yes.
What's left of the door frame, where it's just rotted. This is what's left of the wood and everything that's fallen apart. So we're just about to renew all of that.
But it's time that has taken my tomorrows.
That's the old toilet. That's good.
Oh, how many days I'm going to end this one? But
no.
I'm talking of the amount of money you're going to give me.
Yeah. And I say 2,000.
That's it. Add another 5. That's another 5. That's it. I'll be satisfied with that one. Sure.
Okay, we'll discuss after. I'll see if it's straight.
No, it's what I said.
Also, while I'm renovating the health clinic, also the maternity ward, what we built 2 years ago, hasn't been opened due to no beds and many other small issues that I've just been ironing out this year. So here are the beds, and we're just about to put the mosquito nets up, ready for the opening next week. We've just been decorating them all. We've been waiting for these beds for 2 years, and now they've just arrived. So it's been a long struggle, but we're there. Each time you drive a truck, you always meet people along the way and give them lifts. And these two guys, the little kid's really sick. He's not so well. He's going to hospital. So we're going to give them a lift 3/4 of the way, because I'm just heading that way now. So it's always a big problem here. And when you're in a rural area of no transport, it's hard work.
Yeah.
Also, what we're going to do tomorrow, we're going to get a mezuzah, because as I was driving down the road 2 weeks ago, I saw this kid here who got burnt, very similar to a friend of mine. A lot of the kids, they roll over and fall in the fires. It's one of the worst problems in Malawi for young kids, and they end up just falling in. We're going to sort him out tomorrow. There he is. Hello. Yeah. So, as you can see, his eyes are really burnt and he's got no eyelids left, and the side of his head and where the skin's stretched so much. So hopefully we can take him to Mazuzu Central the last time I went with a very similar problem of a daughter, it was a lot of hard work. We went back and forward so many times. Breaks my heart, man, you know what I mean? Like, kids are just left here and, you know, that's just, what is it, left down to destiny, is it, that I happen to drive by in some big 4x4 truck to help out some kid? Doesn't seem fair, does it? Just while I'm talking about the kids falling in the fire, my friend's daughter fell in the fire just a couple of years ago, and trying to get assistance from Malawi hospital was a lot of hard work, and I just saw her walking down the road now. She's a lot better, and we did think that she wasn't going to make it, bless her. Show you that in all areas of rural Malawi they're all cooking on open fires, and so this is what the deal is here, just here, so you can just see. Yeah, everybody's like this. So as you can imagine, like, the kids look after the babies and the parents are often farming in the fields, and the kids fall in these fires, mate, and get burnt to cinders. One of the other projects is that we are going to do malaria nets for babies, cages, and I've just given it to this guy who's so far in a week and a half, I guess, not long, much longer, he's made 74 of the cages, and so they're all here, all ready to, as you can see. Look at that, you've done such a good job. Look at that, it's great, so cool. So I think we'll try and get to like 200 of them, maybe even 300 of them, so when the maternity ward opens out, each baby can have one, so it will really help bloody save their lives, because if you get malaria at 1 week, 2 weeks, 3 weeks, up to 3 months old, it's extremely dangerous to try and administrate the anti-malaria drugs such as quinine. Okay, so now I'm in Chisala and just come to see how the next project's going, and as you can see we've got the two blocks from last year in the distance, and just behind us is now the beginning of the third block and final block. They needed one more, but I didn't have the funds for last year, so now we're building this, so that's cool. We're trying to sort out the tables what were donated to them a couple of years ago that have all broken, and now they're rock solid. So the carpenter's doing a great job. So what they've done is got some hardwood along the bottom here, and has made. The jobs this year was to get all the solar panels working for the health clinic, and they've got like two main batteries, what were both not very good, so we would just replace the batteries. Oh, ta-da! Not often things work in Malawi, but at the moment this is. This is Mr. Zimwani's house. This is one of the three houses that we're decorating and renovating and putting new toilets on. Are you happy that your house has been decorated?
Yeah, I'm very happy.
It looks much nicer?
I'm very happy.
Yeah?
Yeah.
All right, and well, look, we're just about to give out the some of the mosquito nets for the babies. We're going to give them out from day-old babies to one-month-old babies. We've got 40 here. We've got about another 140-50 coming next week. And so yeah, we're just about to hang them out, but I think we're just about to. Okay. You must tell them.
I'm going to go to the hospital. Cool. Well, look, we've just been to the hospital, and there's an American surgeon there. What's pretty cool. So Dandy is going to hopefully be operated on in the next 2 weeks or so. So that's a very successful day in my books. Cool.